Trisha.
Hi, meet John. John's number one fan is Sharon. Sharon Jeanette Travolta. Now, her friends are here to tell her to ditch the cardboard cutout and get a real man.
That's right, Trisha. How can she be in love with that? She ought to get into the real world.
Well, Trisha, he's the one that I want, and my friends have to just accept me for the way I am. Right, this is me. That's today's Trisha. Concerned about their friend's fever. Saturday night fever, that is.
That's right, Trisha. It's about time Sharon got rid of her childhood crush and found herself a real man.
Never. He's the only one for me.
Right, we'll see if they can change her mind after the break. Welcome back. My next guests say they're being driven around the bend by a certain person's obsession. So let's welcome Charmaine and Sue. Talking about your twin sister, Sharon, and her obsession with...
John Travolta.
John Travolta. When we say obsession, are we talking a teenage crush here?
Oh, no, Trisha, no.
How old is she?
34.
Like you. OK, and she's had this crush since...?
She was 12.
Since she was 12. Now, we say crush. Are we talking, what, a couple of posters, the odd autograph?
No.
Well, what are we talking
it's
about?
It's a nightmare, honestly. You wouldn't believe it. It's, I'm so embarrassed. I really am. It's just like she's basically living with the man. She knows everything about him.
Like
she's,
what, when you say
she's
everything?
Got a copy of his birth certificate. She sends emails to him. she phones him up at his restaurant.
Does he have a phone back or respond to the
emails? No, because they said that they're not allowed to give that sort of information out.
Right, so she's sending emails and what have you. What, she's mad in love with him?
Yeah, she's actually met him and it's gone worse. And the worst thing is, believe it or not, she changed her name by default to him.
So what's her name now?
Sharon John Travolta.
She legally did that. How old was she when she did that?
I'm not really sure because I don't really pay interest in it. I hate it. I'm embarrassed and ashamed about it all.
So does her whole life, let me ask you as a friend, Charmaine, her whole life revolves around John Travolta?
It all revolves around John Travolta. I mean, ever since I've known her about 9 years.
Yeah.
And everything she talks about and everything she does is just John Travolta.
So she sees all these movies, what, once or twice?
Oh, no, no. I mean, if she goes to see a movie, she goes to the cinema as soon as she knows the day it's showing.
Yeah, yeah.
And she won't sit through it once. She'll probably sit three or four times.
What, at a go?
Yeah, go in the morning.
And then she'll probably queue a few hours to see it. And, I mean, look who's talking. She went to see that, I think it was about 22 times. And then, not only after she's seen the film, she'll go and buy the video, but she won't buy one copy. She'll probably buy four or five copies.
Of the same
and
video?
And if it's on the television, she'll tape it as well.
She'll go in the cinema.
It's just absolutely out of control, you know.
Yeah.
I mean, it's
and
right
we've actually, we've got some, before we meet her, let's explain what this is like. We've got some, a piece of video, and we actually get to have a look at her, where's this? This is her room, is it? That we're seeing.
Yes.
And these are all the posters. This is her room. These are the videos everywhere. Like you said, pictures since he was little. Since he was at college? Since he was born?
She's got pictures when he's a baby.
Pictures when he's a baby. And here we go, what, those are all the videos you talked about. She's bought all of those videos and what, she sits there and watches them one after the other, does she?
Yeah.
Is she rich?
How did she feel? She must be, she's madly in love with him. How did she feel when he got married?
She was devastated. Mm.
Really devastated?
I thought she was going to top herself.
You're joking.
No, she got really, really bad.
Yeah. So what about the baby now? What about the children?
Well, that was just as bad.
Has she sort of come round now?
No, it's like Sharon, she's sort of like, well, with anybody else normally, right? You're like your pop stars and everything, you go through a phase, and then you grow out of it.
But this phase has never ended.
No, it's gone worse by the minute.
Well, I think we should meet the woman in question, so come on in, Sharon. Sharon, you sit there and watch movies 22 times and...
Oh, even more than that as well.
So what does John Travolta mean to you?
I just think he's fantastic. He's a fantastic actor, fantastic singer, dancer. He can just do everything, not to mention how good-looking he is as well.
So is he a man that you wish you were married to?
Well, I don't know. Might be a different story if I was married to him.
It might
be. I just idolise him as a film star, really.
As a film star?
Yeah.
But you've got his birth certificate?
Yeah.
You've got pictures of him since he was a baby?
Yeah. But since he was, like, 3 months old, and then I've got a book of him with pictures of him growing up from 3 months to, like, the present day.
So, Charmaine, what is it you want to say to Sharon today?
Well, I think it's just about time she sort of got a life, you know, and grew out of this teenage crush. I mean, she's 34, and it just frightens me because I think now she's getting older.
Yeah.
I mean, her life revolves around John Travolta, and she's not, like, giving herself time to meet anybody else. And I'm just frightened that she's going to end up old and on her own. And, I mean, if anything ever happened to John Travolta, you know, I don't know what she'd do.
I'm really happy in my life, though, because all the relationships I've had in the past, those men have been losers.
Aren't you afraid that you're going to be lonely for the rest of your life if you're just aiming for John Travolta and saving yourself for him?
Well, I'm not saving myself for him. I just like watching his movies and all that kind of thing.
But you're not really getting out there and meeting other men. You're fixating on John Travolta.
Well, yeah, that's true. But tell you the truth.
And no other man could compete with that, could they?
No, I don't suppose they could. But all the relationships I've had in the past, I've just had bad relationships, so I've given up on relationships now.
John Travolta's your refuge.
Yeah, that's how I feel at the moment.
Okay.
Can I just say that I think John Travolta's wonderful anyway. You're quite right to idolise him, but don't judge other men by him.
No.
Otherwise, you're going to get hurt and you're going to put an emotional barrier up and nobody will be able to get through at all.
Good point.
Yeah.
Thank you. Thank you.
I'd like to ask you, all the boyfriends you said that were losers, did you ever compare them to John Travolta?
No.
Did they have to feel they had to compete with John Travolta?
Yeah. I think they did feel like they was competing with him.
Of course they were.
Well, especially when you've got more photos of John Travolta than you have your boyfriends.
Well, that's just the way I am.
So as a sister, Sue, do you worry about, you know, your twin being locked away, being madly in love, idolising John Travolta?
It scares me, because, I mean, I love her to bits. She's
so
brilliant.
So can you tell her how you feel?
I love you to bits, right? You're a great girl. I mean, you are popular. You've got loads of friends. But I'm worried about you. I'm really scared because I think you have really got a serious problem. And it scares me. It really does. Because I think you do need some professional help.
Why can't every man be like a picture of John Travolta? Because at least you can put it away when you've had enough on it.
No, but seriously, let's come back to this. I mean, that's how your sister feels. She feels she's got a serious problem. What do you say to that?
I don't think that I've got a problem. It's just kind of
like
my hobby.
Well, you tell her how you feel about it.
I don't think I've got a problem. It's my hobby, and that's just what I like to do.
Fair enough.
But I think she's wasting some of her life, because you could be going out there doing other things instead of just shutting yourself in your flat and looking at John Travolta all the time.
What's better to do than that?
All right, well, look, Sharon, you've got a friend here to support you, so please welcome Francis.
Hello, Trish.
Oh, I wonder what you think about this.
Well, Sharon is a fantastic person. And as long as she's happy and she's not hurting anybody, then what's wrong with it? I mean,
dust the T-shirts, leave Sharon alone campaign 99.
Yeah, I've known Sharon for 3 years. And all the time I've known her, she's been a Travolta fan. And you just accept her for what she is. And you should accept her for what she is. She can't change and she's never going to change. So, you know, and even she's got permission from John Travolta himself, sending her letters. Oh. So, I mean, he's even encouraging it himself.
Yeah, he says I'm his number one fan of all time.
So, really?
So, can he agree?
After that,
I can't understand. Okay.
The thing that worries me is I feel there's maybe something missing in your life, and you kind of, you fill that gap up with the idea, the sort of fixation that you have about him. Is that true?
I don't think there's anything missing out my life. I'm quite happy the way life is at the moment.
You're quite happy?
Yeah, okay. I'm not interested in getting married or having kids or nothing like that.
You're not interested in that?
No.
So can you see yourself at, say, age 80 still
being the same as I am now? Yeah.
What happens when John Travolta's not around?
Then her friends
what you're going to do with your life?
Her.
Yeah.
Then
her
friends and family are there, which they should be there
I've still got
now.
All his pictures and everything and his videos and to carry on.
I know a 83-year-old lady who is a big fan of Elvis Presley. She had photographs, everything that was going on Elvis Presley. But when Mr. Right came along, she said that she knew he was Mr. Right. She got married, she had a family, but she still had Elvis Presley's things all around. And she's in her 80s, so... Really,
well, there you go. You can have it both. You can have it all. All right. Thank you. Well, look. Sharon, unfortunately, I mean, we tried, no, I lie, but unfortunately, John Travolta wasn't able to make today's show. No, sorry, sorry. But we do have the next best thing. Today.